happy heavily 60th birthday to the late great legendary guru of Gangstar, X-Man 1991, aka Xavier here. I want to apologize that I did not get a chance to do this Attitude Era rant of yesterday. Reminiscing 20 years of Stone Cold Steve Austin helping Team WWF from the July 16th, 2001 edition of Raw is War. But before I get into that, got some bad news for all you hip-hop fans out there. I know you heard the news yesterday, and this is not a rumor, it is the truth. Biz Markie. You all know who Biz Markie is, legendary hip-hop artist, songwriter, beatboxer, DJ. May he rest in peace. Biz Markie died yesterday in the Baltimore hospital due to complications of diabetes, 57 years old, taken away way too fucking soon. 57 is a young age. I don't think 57 is old. He fought a whole year to get his health back, and sadly that he lost his battle of diabetes. But his music and legacy will definitely live on. It's gonna be hard for me to listen to these songs by Biz now that he's gone. Damn, we're losing too many fucking legends of hip hop this year. Prince Markie D, DMX, Black Rob, Shock G, and now Biz Markie. Who next? But I want to thank Biz Markie for everything that he's done for hip hop. My condolences and prayers goes to his wife and his family. There were spreading rumors saying on June 30th and July 1st that he died, but Biz Markie's wife and Big Daddy Kane revealed that he was still alive and fighting, and he passed away 16 days later. So, with that being said, may Biz Markie rest in peace. And before we get this Attitude Era rant started, we definitely need to have a moment of silence for Biz Markie, because he is definitely going to be missed. Thank you. Now we get this Attitude Era rant started. This took place 20 years ago on the July 16th, 2001 edition of Raw is War. The last Raw is War before the 2001 invasion. And that is my boy, the toughest SOB of the WWE, the Bionic Redneck, the host of Broken Skull Sessions, the Texas Rattlesnake, and WWE Hall of Famer, Stone Cold Steve Austin, helping Team WWF take out Team WCW and ECW. Look at this. Wow, look at it.
Looks like it's being outmanned and outnumbered right now. No doubt that we are outnumbered by ECW and WCW.
Hold up. Oh, there he is. That's right. There he is. Okay, come on. That's one stunner. That's two. That's three. Four. Five. Six. Seventh. Man, JR. Oh, wait.
Hey, hold on a second. Stay right there. You think what you said in there had any impact at all?
Hey, Freddie. You think that what Stone Cold Steve Austin just did out there?
You think that the WWF is going to have any impact at all? Any impact at all this Sunday on ECW and WCW? The answer is no.
But I tell you what will have a lot of impact. You see, Freddie, because you and the WWF have a lot in common. You're both about to die.
Get him out of here. Go!
Man, brings back memories. Man, Jim Ross looked sound like he was gonna lose his voice. But Jim Ross, no doubt, is the best commentator of pro wrestling history. So we got the old Stone Cold back, the foul mouth, beer drinking, swelling, toughest SOB who don't trust anybody. I can't wait till next week's Throwback Thursday to show y'all highlights of the 2001 invasion. So my apologies that I didn't get a chance to do this yesterday. I'm doing this a day later than ever. So that does it for my late Attitude Era rant, reminiscing 20 years of Stone Cold Steve Austin helping Team WWF from the July 16, 2001 edition of Raw is War. I'm gonna try to see tomorrow if I can do a reaction remembering the late, great Biz Markie. If you smell what the Rock is cooking. And that's the bottom line, 'cause Stone Cold said so.